now it's this venison pie. I have taken 1.5 pounds of venison and I've put it in that basic marinade that we did in the last recipe. I've strained off the venison. You can see it's gone a slightly different colour. And there is the marinade underneath. That's without all the bits in it. So I've taken out the onion, the peppercorns, the bay leaf, and the garlic. Now, you didn't see in the last recipe in the pâté that I'd taken that out. It was under the onion. So it's all out, and I'm going to make up the marinade with stock to be about a pint. Now, you can see this is really good stock, made with some game bones and also some good beef bones. And I'm going to fry the other ingredients. I've got in the pan some bacon pieces, and they were very fatty, and they are now nice and crispy brown. I took the bacon pieces, and I let the fat run out of them first, so I didn't put any fat to fry them in. Then I added some onion and some German sausage. The reason why I put German sausage when I made this recipe up was because in Germany they eat a lot of venison, and I've used a sausage like this one. It's about 3 ounces in weight. So those are well fried together. I'm going to thicken it with a good ounce of flour. Stir that in and mix it well together. Doesn't need to colour, just to mix it well together. Then add the marinade and the stock. Imagine, you see there's half a pint of wine in this. But again, for that marinade, it really needn't be the very, very most expensive. It can be the cheapest you can get. So mix all that in. Now, when you use red wine, it's usually a sort of pinky colour, and so it's quite a good idea to add some gravy browning too, which I'm going to do in a minute. Then a little bramble jelly, because it's autumn, it's bramble time, a tablespoonful. I can't get a tablespoon in my little pot. I usually make jelly in little pots because I find that's the most popular. So mash that well down. And then we come to the seasoning. Plenty of ground black pepper. I think I shall have that put on my gravestone. Plenty of ground black pepper and salt, about 2 teaspoonfuls of salt. Stir that well in together. Now that's all the ingredients except for gravy browning. And I'm just going to put a little squirt. I keep it in one of these squeegee bottles. I think the children had ice cream sauce in it, but it's very good, and I keep that by the cooker, and it's all in one box. Stir that together. Now all that remains is for me to put the venison in. And then you can either, you bring this to the boil, and you can either cook it in a pan like this and simmer it very gently for 2 or 3 hours until tender, or you can put it into the oven, bring it to the boil and put it into the oven if you've got the oven on, and cook it until it's tender, really tender. And then turn it into a pie dish, which I've done here. And what I didn't tell you was, I forgot my beautiful bouquet garni. That should have gone. Should I just slip it in now on top here? In goes the bouquet garni to give lots of flavour. So, and then put it into a pie dish, and then pull out the bouquet garni, let it get stone cold, and then put a rim of pastry around the outside. I've used a 14-ounce packet. Put a handleless cup in the middle, or perhaps you're lucky and you've got one of those things to support pastry, blackbirds or something. I haven't got one. Pie funnel, the word comes to me. Then brush round the outside with egg. I can hear that just coming up to the boil, the pan, so I shall keep an eye on it. And then take the pastry, roll it out, and then just lift it over the top. If you've got some surplus flour, shake it off. And having a cup is even better than a pie funnel, because it's nice to rest it on in the middle. Pull that over the top. Then with a sharp knife, at an angle, put your hand underneath, don't drop it, and then go around with a knife at an angle, all the way around. The reason for doing it at an angle like this, as I think I've told you when I've been making steak and kidney pie, is that if you do it like that, the pastry has got, can shrink back in a little bit. So there are the pastry pieces for making a nice leaves if you want to. Then bash up the sides. Do you know, at college we were always told to do it with the back of the knife. Well, these sort of French cook's knives are too thick to use the back of the knife. All the way around. The reason for doing this is to make it rise in nice flakes. Now, you could, this needn't necessarily be a venison pie. You could do it with any casserole game, doing it exactly the same way, putting it in a marinade first. 2 days in the marinade in the refrigerator till all the flavours have got in, all the way around. Then the pinching, hold the knife. Now some people hold it in this hand, you do it just as you like. All the way around. It's rather nicer than a fork, it looks more professional. Now I'm always being asked about freezing things. Not only am I always being asked, I enjoy freezing things myself. If you want to freeze this pie, you can do it after you've done the decoration like this around the edge and put the leaves. Don't brush it with egg. Put it straight in the freezer, allow it to set, then cover it with cling film, and it'll keep in the freezer for a couple of months. Then brush over with egg before baking, but at this stage put it back in the fridge again. That'll set the pastry, and then when it comes to baking it, it will keep its shape and not all shrink inside. Now I'm going to look in the oven and see how the one is that I've put in to bake. I'm baking it in a hot oven, and it will take about 30 minutes, something like that. Gosh, it looks good. It wants to be this lovely crispy brown colour, well risen at the sides. Great advantage of having a drop-down door into your oven is that you've got something to rest the food on. I'm just going to move that to one side. Now it is very, very hot. Let's have a look and see how it cuts. With a sharp knife, just go around the edge of the lip and then cut a V out. Lift up the pastry, which should be nice and risen. It's lovely and flaky. I'll just put that to one side. And as I mentioned, it should be nice and saucy to sop up the potatoes. There we have the venison, the onion, and the sausage too. Now let me give you the recipe. Gamekeeper's venison pie. You'll need 1.5 pounds of stewing venison, 1/2 pint of marinade, that's the basic marinade, 4 ounces of fatty bacon cubed, 3 ounces of German smoked sausage, skinned and sliced, 1 large onion chopped, a generous 1 ounce of flour, about 1/2 pint of stock, a bouquet garni, a tablespoonful of bramble jelly. Now, if you haven't got bramble jelly, you could have, of course, used red currant jelly. 2 teaspoonfuls of salt, freshly ground black pepper, and a dash of gravy browning. And then for the pastry topping, a 14-ounce packet of puff pastry, if it's frozen thawed, a little egg or milk for glazing. And then you bake it in a hot oven, which is 425 degrees Fahrenheit, 220 degrees centigrade, gas number 7, for about 30 minutes.